I have crippled my caravan since the monster.
Hello, Milos. Bite of Anubis. Hello, George. Hello, Turtle.
Tread lightly and with speed.
With light, with speed. Very nice. Hello, Yorgos Argyropoulos. After your day, I'd like 2 months of work, you make sure you get a good laptop. Yeah. Turtle, I hope you can get a good laptop. Playing this game with a controller. With a controller on a good laptop is going to be awesome. Are you sure that you are going to get a laptop? First of all, let me pick up all of the yellow items. I have to pick up yellows and send them. Make some gold. You've played on PC before, it is so much better than controller. Yeah, it is. It is. You know, it is this type of game that it is better to play with a keyboard because you have too many shortcuts, hotkeys, instant access to many hotkeys. And at least for this game, it helps very much having a keyboard. Hello, Dark Knight. I said don't it never will address people who play PC games with PS or Xbox controller. Milos, I am not playing games with PS or Xbox controller. I play Titan Quest with a generic gamepad. It is not PS, it is not Xbox. Yes! I guess you understand this one. It is Trust. Trust GXT24. Trust this one. So, no PS4, no Xbox, no Steam controller, nothing.
Much love from Germany.
Acer Flash, thank you very much for the donation. Wait, why? This YouTube studio is broken as hell. I wonder when they will fix the problems of the YouTube studio. Come on. Hello, Night Phoenix. Maybe a classic Atari joystick, yeah. Popo, Dark Knight, Atari. Atari, I think Atari 2600 was my first console ever. 45,000 years ago, no. Okay. Should I try to play this character, this build with the controller? I don't think it is a good idea. The 2600 was awesome and the sounds were amazing. Ah, so you have played with that one. What is the attack speed? 199%. Those two, any kind of controller, it's an Eric or whatever, I don't understand why if a game doesn't have PC version, okay, but a PC on controller, why? Milos, I don't know, but I guess that some people, they play consoles, they are used to playing with controller or consoles, then later they buy a PC, or somehow they decide to start playing the same game on PC. Because they have seen that on PC that game is better, it has more coded, or maybe because it has mods and other things, who knows why. And then they decide to go on PC and play the game, but since they are used to controllers of consoles, maybe they want to play with the controller. Grizzly Ziz, thanks for subscribing, welcome. Of course, I still have at home a 2600 still working. Still working. Wow. No, unfortunately, my 2600 was it broke down many years ago, decades. For the love of everything, that is only get 1% more. I don't know if I can. Actually, I can. I can put a really correct arm here. I have kept a charm for this item, but if I remember correctly, yes, I think it is the Primal Magma, but I have to level up to level 60 to be able to use it. This is why I haven't used it yet. Hello Stefan Mikhail and also Arche Paladin. Wait, Dark Knight, is there an emulator for PC of Atari 2600? Milos, one-handed weapons and the shield, it is 222%. The maximum attacking speed you can have. It is funny how Titan Quest is nearly as old as I am, but I still love it. Yeah, the game is awesome. It is still absolutely amazing. Oh, an epic reward, epic ring, this one, reward. Shadow formed band. What? This is a ring I haven't found many times. Maybe I have found... Wait. I think this is the first time I find this ring. I don't remember having on any of my other rings that I have in my collection of items attack damage convert to health. Awesome. Cyclops Burger. Nah, not today. You gonna play Atari games? No, I don't want to do no. To be honest, Dark Knight these days, I want to play is Titan Quest and Minecraft Dungeons, nothing else. You already have a copy of on one of your spears. Do you mean Paladin of this ring here? How many? I have 6 total deaths. This character started from level 1 in normal, and now we are in epic. Found an awesome item today. What item? I got amazingly lucky on Casino Merchant. I got a Titanic Seed of the... Oh! Tinkerer. The spear who summons me. Yeah, but that one, Paladin, is... it belongs to the mod Shadow Champions. Milos, I was trying to farm a Tinkerer items in Atlantis shops, and even though I was looking for a specific a Tinkerer bracers for this lot here, instead of that one, I found three jewels. I think one was a ring and two amulets. One of the amulets was the Sentinel's amulet of the Tinkerer. Sentinel's is the stat that the prefix that provides, I think, +2 to all skills in defense mastery of the Tinkerer, which is awesome. And I got two more great jewels from the shops, not necessarily Tinkerer jewels. One was Tinkerer, the other one, I think it was not. But I don't remember right now. Hello, Artorias. Tracker deep sea treated of the storm, what? Deep sea treated of the storm. Trackers, +2 to tracker provides +2 to rogue mastery. I don't remember. Or hunting. Why do all of your bits have the key of the Warden of Souls? What do you mean? Because all of my bits go through the Hades of Palace, and they pick up the key of that key. Icer Flash, my favorite item based on how it looks. It is very hard to say. I like very much the looks of the set Alexander Spanogly, the full set, especially the chest armor. This one is one of my top favorite, the chest armor. But to say which one is my top favorite, I don't know. I cannot do that because I don't know. I cannot decide. I mean, take a look at these items here. This chest armor is one of the best, in my opinion. Also, this shield looks great. There are many items that are super awesome. I cannot really decide. Hello, Almighty One for All. +2 to hunting, yeah, trackers. Assassins is +2 to rogue, and what else did I say? I don't remember anyway. Hello, Kosan. Hello, Ladger Lou. Yeah, Trojan armor is beautiful. Yeah, Trojan is awesome. Trojan is awesome, it is one of the best as well. Yesterday you found a super awesome looking shield with your thrown weapon build. Which one? I said flash. Is it an epic or a legendary shield? Ying and Yang swords. Those swords, yeah, those swords look great, especially. Not the icon of the swords, the graphic in the inventory. When you hold them here, the 3D graphics, they look great. Legendary shield. By the way, I forgot to upgrade this one, of course. I don't have a legendary upgrade available right now to go and upgrade this one, but I could go and upgrade it with an epic tier of an upgrade. This one is upgraded in legendary difficulty. This one is upgraded, this one upgraded, this one upgraded. Only this one is not upgraded. Ah, ανεξάρτητος. Ανεξάρτητος, by the way, Isoflash is a Greek word. It means independent. Ανεξάρτητος. So, in Greek, if you want to say I am independent, in Greek, you say είμαι ανεξάρτητος. So, ανεξάρτητος legendary shield is the shield of independence. This game is meant to you. PC took you 3 minutes to get stone butter cuffs. Yeah, turtle. This happens in I think in normal difficulty it is easier to find some rare tier mastery frequent items, rare mastery frequent items, than in legendary. Legendary is much harder to find these items. I think it is similar to the Adamantine Sickle of Kronos. Because in normal difficulty, it is very very easy to get the Adamantine Sickle of Kronos, even the first time you fight the boss, the Telkin. But in legendary, or maybe in epic as well, you have to farm the boss more. If I have Steam and Titan Quest and everything installed and I download Steam and Titan Quest again, Turtle, for this thing, no, to get all of your characters and saves of Titan Quest in another machine after you install Steam again, you need to use the Steam Cloud feature of Steam. On the first machine, you have to activate Steam Cloud on the first machine. Your save files will be uploaded to the Steam Cloud. And on the second machine, another PC, a laptop, whatever, you install again Steam, you install again the Titan Quest, and then when you load the game to play, automatically the Steam Cloud will download your save files of Titan Quest. But since many players have problems with Steam Cloud and they lose their progress and saves, it is better to do these things manually. Make backups of your saves of Titan Quest and other games as well on Steam on something like this one, a flash drive. And then after you install Titan Quest in another machine, copy and paste the backups to the other machine, to the right folders, and you will be 100% certain that you will never lose your saves. Kyosan, I'm fine. Hello, how are you? Hello, Diego Alonso. You had the same answer from someone else. Ah, okay. Yeah, Titan Quest saves are very important and I will never risk losing them by using Steam Cloud and other similar services. And then getting overheat. Overheat, what do you mean, Paladin? You are good, Kyosa. Nice. I hope everybody is good. I'm also good. Don't the devices need to be like next close to each other? No, Turtle, you do these things via internet.
What? You say convergence mode.
You... The Steam Cloud works, it is an internet feature. You upload to the servers of Steam the files, if you want. If you want to use the Steam Cloud. And then on the other machine from the internet you download the files. It doesn't have to be an external PC. Ah, you mean Paladin, if you lose your characters, yeah. It is very bad. Losing characters. I lost my collection of items and that was very, very, super, very bad. Imagine if I have lost my characters. This would have been much, much worse than losing my collection of items. Let's not forget after all that on your, if you lose your characters, you already lose many, many great items as well. Because your characters are not naked, they use items. And since all of, not all, most of my characters have played even legendary difficulty, this means that 99% of my characters are equipped with great items. Losing her bananas? Ah, I have bananas. Last night, after all, I had my yogurt, and instead of a peach, I had a banana. At the last second, I decided to eat a banana instead of a peach. It is the son of a peach.
It's all my fault.
It is, my dude, it is. It is always your fault. It is always all your fault.
I thought I would be a hero. I should have. There's no hope of stopping.
You thought you would be a hero, and then you became Father Guts. What scenario would you like, mythological or not, for a sixth act of TQ? I was wondering when I saw the mice I had built yesterday, they asked you which act you like. Look, I wouldn't say no to many different mythologies. You know, Native American mythology would be awesome. More Asian mythology would be awesome. Maybe Japanese mythology. More African mythology. Bring mythology, whatever you want, it doesn't matter. So long as the new act is made in the right way, because Ragnarok is awesome, but the biggest mistake, the big mistake of Ragnarok act is that it is super huge. And this game doesn't need super huge acts. It is not an open world game. It is not about exploring the game. So long as they make this act to be in the right way, the layouts and everything, the design of the act is in the right way, I don't mind. I would like to have Native American, especially Native American mythology, and maybe Japanese mythology, and maybe, why not, if we get Japanese mythology, we can get some a mastery, samurai mastery, ninja mastery. You have an idea for Cyrus somatic build, but you need those revenant armor? Yeah, Milos, those items are very rare. When can we expect the three bits in one video? Turtle! My plan is to start working on that video, but look, this week, maybe next week, the video will come. But I'm thinking now, maybe I should break this video down to four videos. The first video would be, I would be showcasing all three builds in the first video, mostly some gameplay, some boss fights, and some generic info for the builds. And then I would have three other videos. Each one of the videos would be more analytical build guide videos for each one of the builds. So the first one would be the introductory video, and the three next videos would be the build guide videos. Maybe I will do it this way. I think maybe this way is better, because if I do it this way, all of the videos will be, you know, smaller in size and duration, and I think this will be the best for everybody. Because if I make only one video, and I put three build guide videos and also gameplay, this video will be at least 1 hour long. So I don't know, what do you think? Do you think I should make only one video? Or maybe more. Maybe more devices, enemies and bosses in new DLC. Yeah, Paladin, I would like that, yeah. Hello, Doodle. How do you pick up God with one click? Ninja Gaiden. to pick up gold, you go to options menu, keep binding. Here it says quick pickup. You assign a hotkey here, you click the hotkey and you pick up gold potions and components. But this is a feature of Titan Quest Anniversary. It doesn't exist in Immortal Throne. As long as it is before I get my laptop, it's okay. Aha! Didn't you say those three bits are going to be level 85 when you post a video of them? Yeah, Milos, yes, of course. I wouldn't mind one long video. Okay, Milos, I don't know, I will see. You wouldn't mind, I also wouldn't mind, but, you know. Maybe many other people would mind, I don't know. Well, at least the only certain thing is that tomorrow you will see a new build guide video, which is a new build of mine. And it is a bit of a meme build, maybe. You decide when you see that video. And we will see if you like it or not. You got 2 months. Turtle, why are you going to get a new laptop in 2 months? Can you imagine how flushed I was when I first went to the Lemberg in the Ragnarok? It's basically a real mountain. 20 kilometers away from your home. Wow. Hello, studio. So, how does it feel, Acer Flash, when you play a game where you visit a place which is only 20 kilometers away from your home? Thank you. Boss fight! Come on. Call of the Wild. At least I got one blue item. First, you couldn't believe it. Birthday money plus 1-2 months of work and boom. What about you, Fai? You see Macedonia in Odyssey? Yeah, I see Macedonia in Odyssey. I'm visiting the exact place where my city is in Macedonia in Odyssey, but the city is not there. And I don't really care, to be honest, I don't care. This is Pepe build, nope.
You, thank you, stranger.
You hate this boss, why Dark Knight? Why do you hate this boss? Hello, Pan Camille. Where is my coffee? In any other game, it wouldn't be something special, but you grew up with Titan Quest. This is a very special experience. Titan Quest has something very magical, very unique. You can never say goodbye to Titan Quest. If you can truly feel what Titan Quest is, if you connect with Titan Quest once, this is it. Had bad stun reset you used to stun you to do... Okay. Yeah, this is the move of that boss actually. The big move. You were born in 2002, a Titan Quest came out in 6, yeah. Pan Camille, I'm fine, I'm doing well, how are you? I'm okay. Hello Panagioti. The day will come when Fai will know where is his coffee. That day is today. Maybe. Tau, tau! This build is freaking awesome. By the way, there are no Thessaloniki notices. Why was the city founded later? Yes, studio, it was founded later. Much later, I would say. I don't remember exactly when, but it was founded later. Κατέβασε το χαρακτήρα σου. Αχα, Παναγιώτη! Did you install the Line of Epic Heroes character? Not bad, just taking a break from farming arts. Artsmith's class! Just reminded me, Pan, you just reminded me the build I play these days in Minecraft Dungeons, which relies on cooldown reduction heavily. And you reminded me of that one because of the Archimedes clasp. provides up to 45% recharge reduction. Which is cooldown reduction. You making more secret code of the Illuminati? Paladin, I don't know what exactly you mean, but I make nothing of Illuminati. Panagiotti, yeah, this was the idea of that build, to put in the stash. Rare and great items for the community to use. Even though the Dragonborn sword is a cheat one and I should go and delete it actually. But anyway, it doesn't matter now. Alexander the Great was from Athenopolis, the Thessaloniki was here during the Roman reign. Yeah. It was during the Roman reign. I don't remember actually when Thessaloniki was created, established, whatever. Right now you're gonna eat two souvlaki. Now, Panagioti. It is very early in the evening. How far do you think you'll get in today's stream, Tifon, maybe Hades? No, not that far. I mean, I'm still in approximately the half of 48 act. Yes, I think I will reach Tifon, but not Hades, no. Ah, Panayoti, then that makes sense. Okay. We have a boss fight here now. No! What was that? Did you see that? Tell me you saw that. If you didn't see that, I quit. I quit. I delete my channel. I mean, if you missed this one, what's the point of this channel anymore? Yet it got deleted. Come to Papa, buddy. Are you hacking? Nope, I'm not. Never. The town where you live, Thessaloniki. Yeah, Milos. Flying Yet is also. Love visiting Amphipolis. Cassandra saying I'm sure this will become a great empire someday. Yeah. It is, it is. Studio, yeah, this is super duper awesome. I'm thinking these days maybe to make some content from Odyssey again, some videos maybe. Hello, wasting time. Turtle. This one is the Iron Fist. This skill comes from the Might of Ephesus artifact. I used this skill on the boss. This is why I destroyed... I set that boss flying here, the Yeti boss. Because I hit the boss with this skill. And as you can see, this skill deals 4000 physical damage, 4000 fire damage at the same time, and it also applies burn damage. And since this is epic difficulty and the boss doesn't have so much health points, so many health points, this skill was super duper very powerful against that boss. It took, I hit the boss once with this one, and the boss goes away flying. It became a bird, the Yeti bird. Not a good day to you. You opened the Patreon, nobody joined in. I don't know what you mean, wasting. I delayed so much my fix on Odyssey, I just don't find the motivation these days. Ah, yeah, Studio, sometimes you have to take a break. Turtle, yeah! This skill in Epic... wait, I will probably reach the phone today. We will see what we will do against the phone. What this skill will do on the phone. Oh. Yesterday you played more Chaos Bane, you don't recommend it at all, literally there are only 6 little dungeon maps. There is no overworld map. Wow. Use the RF skill on a level 1 satyr.
Sky smiles on the trail. Earth gently holds his feet. Day and night are a soft song the great spirit sings.
Shadow formed band.
Peace find you.
Da 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 da. Can you give us a hint about the three builds, four video builds? The only hint I will give you, Turtle, is that these builds are very special, nothing more. This build is also special. And also, one of these three builds maybe it is if not more powerful than Hercules build, at an equal level of power, I would say. Maybe. It is very, very powerful. Which means one of the builds is a melee build. This is it. I share no more info. You will see. It will come. They will come. You will see. Hope not as powerful as the Telkin from Atlantis. Do you mean the builds? That's the most weak boss of the game. The Telkin of Atlantis, you think that it is the most weak boss of the game? What about the Telkin of Act 1, Act 2, Act 3? Yeah, because the Skovolos built the legendary. I finished that build a long time ago in Ragnarok as well, but to be honest, I don't remember if I have finished the Skovolos on Atlantis. I think I have. I also think I have live streamed the Skovolos on Atlantis. I'm not sure. Telkin of Egypt is the easiest one. Maybe take a look at my build after the sim is fresh through enemies on Epic Hack 4. Easter Flash, you can join our Discord server, and there we have also a channel for Titan Quest builds. You can share your build there, and I will see your build there, and many people can see the build there. And you can discuss about other builds as well. You streamed this Kovolos built in Atlantis a couple months ago, but I don't remember if you cleared it. Ah! Yeah, I remember nothing about this Kovolos in Atlantis, actually. Νίκο Σάντλερ, έπαιζα πριν πολλά χρόνια το game και το ξανάρχισα μαζί με τα καινούργια εξπάσια από το Tartaro Set. Νίκο, Tartaro Set is. It is a good set, but you have to use the right masteries and also. The right items for the rest of the slots. It is not one of the very good sets, I would say. At least in my eyes. Do you want me to show you how to throw the discus? The discus. Paladin, no! I don't have any more spears, not even for myself. Whoa! Hey, come on now, really? How did I get stuck again here in this freaking place? Very, very weird stuff. Sometimes I don't understand. Very, very weird. Anytime, Nikos. Guys, did you watch yesterday the new trailer of the new expansion of Path of Exile? Do you play Path of Exile? You saw it this morning. Where do I get the Discord link? Answer Flash, it is down in the description. The Discord link. Albadi, have a good day, Albadi. today and tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. We will see you again. Haven't seen it, does it look good? Look, I don't play Path of Exile. I don't think it is something great. They call it the Harvest expansion, League, whatever. It is not a bad one, but it is nothing, you know, you become a farmer, actually, in that expansion. Nothing special. It looks like you will make your own farm and then kill the mobs that will spawn from it. Yeah. I know so much that said the game. Yeah, Paladin, that game is a bit complicated and many people do not understand it. You haven't seen the trailer? Yeah, Kyo-san, I also don't play Poe anymore. But I think that Poe is overbloated, I would say. With coded endgame systems, and this is not a good thing for the game. I want an actual RPG game to have a variety of endgame systems, but I think that Path of Exile has too many. I think that Grim Dawn right now, or maybe even Warhammer 40k Inquisitor Martyr, they have the best number in numbers endgame systems. For example, Grim Dawn has the dungeon, the Shattered Realms, the endgame dungeon, which is something like the Atlantis dungeon here, the Tartarus. One system, another system is the Bounties, with factions, leveling up factions, and then you have the Nemesis bosses, you level up factions, then you level up factions, enemy factions, they unlock Nemesis bosses, you go and you hunt down Nemesis bosses if you want. Another endgame system is the Crucible mode, but you have to buy this one because it is a DLC that you have to buy to play this endgame mode. You have at least four. You have roguelike dungeons, which is my favorite in Grim Dawn endgame system. Five. Of course, you have the biggest endgame system, the classic one, which play the game again, the campaign with many more different classes, builds and whatnot. Six. You have... am I forgetting something? Anyway, I don't remember something else right now. I think 5 to 6 different endgame systems for a game of this genre is perfect. You don't need more. What button did you press to get in anniversary keybinding? There is this button here, the reset player. I have the hotkey app, the app, but the default one should be K, I think, K, hotkey. Also, Warhammer 40k Inquisitor Martyr has some endgame systems. It has the war zones, very nice nowadays. The Crusades, which is mini campaigns, different types of Crusades, it is not just one, it is 6 or 7 different. It has a couple of other different modes in the game where you play and you do things, other things. It has a classic one which play the game again with other classes and whatnot. It has the turret missions, which is missions that you can farm, and you can also find some secret logs from other missions, and you play secret missions. There are many things as well that I don't remember right now. That Turtle, there is a good chance I will play Soul Visor mod again on livestream. And also Shadow Champions again. But I want to see the expansion of Roguelike Dungeons, probably the best endgame feature in Axie RPG. Wait, Kyo-san, what do you mean? The expansion of Roguelike Dungeons. I guess I'm glad I cannot find the Discord link in the description. You forgot the link to Discord, don't see it. Guys, isn't the link to Discord down in the description of YouTube? But I remember that I have it. Let me see. But I cannot see right now. Wait. Let's go there. Let's go there. Okay, then. I will share it with you in the chat. Here. Really? But I included the link in both descriptions of both Twitch and YouTube. But you know, we are using the new YouTube studio for creators this last couple of months, and it is still in beta. There are some problems, so maybe, I don't know, maybe there is a problem, technical problem there. If you don't navigate your way according your character is crap, if you don't grind enough, you won't have any chance of feel good because the game becomes so fast. Hello CK, you do play Poe from 2012, but it has transformed in Labyrinth of Exile. Too much crap kept in the game. Yeah, I think there has to be a limit on how many endgame systems you have in a game of this genre. Or any other game when it comes to RPG, because mostly, for the most part, RPGs are supposed to be games that you replay, and you replay in different ways. It is not a type, a genre of games where you keep playing, for example, with the same character, and you have 1,000 different endgame systems to keep playing with the same character for the rest of your life. You can do that if you want, of course, it is up to you to decide how you want to play, but it is not the point of the genre. This is not the point of RPG games. Ho 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 ho! Yes! I hit that enemy hero. By the way, this hero enemy could have killed me very easily. At Grim Dawn, an expansion to Roguelike Dungeons, more dungeons plus features to make them more difficult and rewarding. You hate the fact that they have left them on hold in favor of SR. Ah, you mean the Roguelike of the Grim Dawn, yeah. Did you do the link stuff? Because I think I have it. Turtle, yes, yeah. Grim Dawn is offline, so here in Brazil, because of the not so good internet connection, no Poe for you. Yeah, guys, I like Poe, I like it very much, but okay, there are some things in Poe that I really don't like, and these things, they push me away from the game. But if I had time, enough time, I would play Poe. But Poe is a game that I think, if you go to play Poe, you should play Poe as a hardcore gamer, not as a casual gamer. Because this is how you will get the most fun out of it. This is why I don't play Poe anymore. I don't have time. This is my hardcore game. And I'm not going to replace Titan Quest with Poe Poe 2, Poe 3, Poe 4, Popopoe, Poropopoe, or any other game out there. Now, for Titan Quest, I would like to see a couple of more red game systems, but a couple of more, not many. We already have the Tartarus Dungeon, which is very nice, it can get some improvements. If they improve the dungeon, then it can become a very, very, very awesome red game system. Of course, we always have the classic end game system in Titan Quest, which is replay the game with different masteries and, or collect items, farm boss, collect items, min-max your character and things like that. You can always play mods. You like my t-shirt? Really? It's the same thing for you, the internet connection, the online thing. A vitality damage assassin build. Okay, this is controversial, actually. You can do it, but it is controversial, it is not really. He has specs to Dungeon Switch by old school. Nikos, yeah. I have played Dungeon Switch 1, Dungeon Switch 2, Dungeon Switch 3. I have also live streamed these games. You know, every Sunday I play a different, I live stream a different actual RPG game. I started doing this series of live streams about, I think 30 weeks ago. 30 weeks is how much? It is about 4 weeks per month. Wow, half a year. So, this Sunday I will live stream another RPG game, which I bought yesterday, by the way. Hello, Theo Roderick. Da-da-da. The music here reminds me of the cultists in Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Action RPG Sundays is your reason to hope and love. Therefore, Titan Quest is your choice any day. Ah, you just found me. Welcome to the community, Nikos. Welcome to the channel, Nikos. Yeah, I have playlists in the channel of different games and whatnot. One of the playlists is Action RPG Sundays. You can find all of the live streams there of Action RPG Sundays in that playlist. I have other playlist which is Titan Quest Anniversary Build Guides. I have another which is Titan Quest Ragnarok Build Guides. Why? Because before Atlantis was released, there was only Anniversary Ragnarok. And after Ragnarok was released, I decided to start a new playlist because some builds were made back in the era of Titan Quest Anniversary. And I created some builds after Ragnarok came out with the new features of Ragnarok and whatnot and items. So I decided those builds to have them in a playlist of Ragnarok. In about a month, it will be anniversary of this channel. In about a month, you mean 13th of July, if I remember correctly. You like that I organized them well. Well, there is some better organization I can make, I can do here in the channel, but I don't know if I will ever sit down to do it, because it will take me hours to do it. Maybe I will do it, I don't know. Hello, Raphaelis. As if I was back in the habit of murdering Neanderthals again. Yeah, yeah. You know, it is what they say about traveling back to time and killing your grandfather, and which means that if you do that, you will never be born. Something like that. I'm traveling again back to time. I'm killing Neanderthals because these are our ancestors. And why am I doing that? Because I'm trying to kill this one specific Neanderthal which gave birth to my line of ancestors. And because if I do that, then I will be vanished into thin air. I will be disappeared forever. I will be free. Nah. I don't got this kind of freedom yet. I got Titan Quest 2. Neanderthals actually are our ancestors. Yeah. I didn't play this game in so many years, but I started the game because of your videos. I have level 25 warrior and I don't know what to pick for second. Go with Dream. Dream Mastery. Harbinger. Actually, we are descendants of Homo sapiens. Not Neanderthals. Well, opa, op. Titan Quest is making fun of you. Stalwart, Nautilus harness, Popo, I want one day to fight this a veteran's Nautilus harness of the Tinkerer. Can we please fight the veteran's Nautilus harness of the Tinkerer, please? At least once in my lifetime, I want to fight this item. Καλησπέρα, Βασίλη. Όπα. Yeah, but it doesn't really matter. I mean, it doesn't matter if it your ancestors were Neanderthals or Homo sapiens or aliens and whatnot. What matters is that you cannot travel back to time and you know, kill your ancestors. This is impossible. But even, hypothetically, even if it were possible to do that, okay, you travel back to time. Let's suppose, hypothetically, that it is possible to travel back to time to meet your ancestor and kill them. When you travel back to time and you kill your ancestor, this means nothing. You will keep living, everything will be exactly the same. Because you... traveling back to time, it means that you are traveling to the future of you, of yourself. This is the past. This is where your ancestor is. This is the future where you live. This is your current time. This is the past. Okay, can you see my fingers? Yeah. This is your current time. This is the past. You are here. Here. You travel back to time. But while you travel back to time, this travel for you is your future. It is not your past. So in your future, you travel back to time, you kill your ancestor in your future, and you keep living in that time unless you come back to your current time, which again is your future. It is the future of your future. It is not the past of your current present time. So... if scientists won't understand this detail, they will never create the machine that will allow them to travel back to time. Not physically, because this is impossible, but let's say visually, mentally, something like that. Yeah, theories. Actually, we are this. If it is not working, you will bring the Jiporo, the real deal, not the crap from the stores. Wait, what is Jiporo? Theo. I don't know. Every day I stream for exactly the same time, the same amount of hours. Except for Sundays. Wait, what is that again? Too many problems on the chat. Your ancestors were Nixie? Ah, man. This is a torture, Dark Knight. Actually, it branches the reality, so probably you killed your ancestor in another para... yeah. That was an interesting theory. Yeah, I mean, this is the only way you can... travel back to time only if you do not think of the past as the past of your present time. This was a boss fight, but I hit the boss with my chuck, and the boss got killed by my chuck because my chuck was Chuck Norris. No, not really. Sealed off, appease the bull. 10% chance of stun. Ah, you mean Uzo? The one high octane. You mean Tsipuro, CK. Tsipuro. Uzo Tsipuro. Okay, you tried to spell Tsipouro. Okay. Hello, Swift, indeed. Maybe the case that we killed off all the Neanderthals and actually we may be that what caused them to go extinct. Who knows? Do you really like Tsipouro? I don't like Ouzo at Tsipouro. Raphael, the enemies are level 5 because right now I'm playing the beta version of the next patch of Titan Quest, of the next update, which is the controller update, this one. If you do this move, you change to the controller support. And this is the beta version of the patch, and there are some minor bugs here, and one of the bugs is this one. It makes the enemies, the level of the enemies is not showcased in the right way. Hello Zedens! Mobile any good? I don't know, I haven't played mobile of Titan Quest, I don't know. You don't like Ouzo, but Tsipouro is better than tequila? Aha. Tsipouro με καλαμαράκια και θερινά the best. Yeah, καλαμαράκια, Βασίλη, is awesome. It is awesome. I don't know why, but whenever I have calamarakia in a tavern, it is always awesome. I mean, oh, an epic reward. What? Again, this is my second epic reward today. And by the way, I think I don't have this item in my collection. I think this is the first time ever I fight this item. Wow. Ouzo and Tsipouro are good, but Krasi is the best drink after coffee. You need to play with Kratos in Titan Quest. Wait, what do you mean? Do you mean the government build? Super Beast. Ah. Ξενέρωσες με το Borderlands 3 σήμερα. What? I can't run it more than lower settings, and even in lower settings I don't have good FPS. Why, Zedens? Do you have a good PC, Zedens? Opa! No, 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 no! No, 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 no! No damage reflection. Ah, you have a 10-year-old CPU. Okay. Or with Asterix and Obelix. Yeah, Super Beast, but I need to create my SRX build someday. But I don't know when. You have Nvidia GTX 970 at 60GB RAM, but your i7 sucks. Jaden, I think that the way you put it and you say this thing, it looks like if I go to play Borderlands 3, I will have the same problems. This is what I get from what you say. By the way, Jaden's, last night, GGG revealed the new trailer of the new expansion of Path of Exile. What is your opinion? Have you watched that trailer? What do you think about the new expansion? You don't think I have sold CPU? It is not that old, but maybe it is of the same power as yours. So, you saw it?
We saw this. There are rumors that...
With the Granny Sorcerer. Wait, what is a Granny Sorcerer?
These are dangerous, you see.
You have an i7, it is good. You bought it to 2015, it's from the 4th gen. The new crafting recipes that come with the new Ligaroson.
If you are taking the road to Chang'an, leave me.
We sell things for magic users here, not for warriors, okay?
This is massively frequent, but...
Come again.
It was not, you were not too excited with the mechanics. Plant the seeds. Yeah. You will become a farmer in a true farmer in Path of Exile. You have the first generation of i7s. Ah. I heard attacking that bell helps your drops. No, this is not true. This is rumors. Fake news. Fake rumors. After so many years of absence, do you think the devs for TQ will continue to develop this epic game, or is it just another advertising stunt? CK, I really don't know what you mean, because when you say after so many years of absence... What exactly do you mean by absence? I mean, right now, for the last 4 years, the new developers have been working non-stop on this franchise. In 2016, we got the anniversary edition. In the end of 2017, we got Ragnarok expansion. Last May, we got Atlantis expansion. I think it was not last March. In March of 2018, they released Anniversary Edition on consoles. PlayStation, Xbox and Nintendo Switch. About 3 months ago, they released Ragnarok and Atlantis DLC on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One X, I think. And we are waiting in the near future, maybe this summer, probably, they will release Ragnarok and Atlantis on Nintendo Switch as well. And currently, at the same time, they are working on bringing the controller patch on PC. Which is what exactly what I'm playing right now. I'm playing the beta of the next update of Titan Quest, which is the controller update. So, I don't understand what you mean by many years of absence. Do you feel any limitations in certain classes with controller play? Maybe if, not in certain classes, but maybe if you decide to play with as many skills as possible. The only limitation, let me show you. Okay, so we have, you can see right now on the screen that we have this here. These are shortcuts for your skills. And on the other side of the screen, wait, behind the chat window, the window chat here, you can see that we have the 1-2-3 shortcuts for other skills. So, if you play with a controller, all of these are your shortcuts. 4 shortcuts plus 4, 8, and 3 here, 11. This is it. Now, maybe with some classes you would decide to play with all of the active skills that the class provides to you. Active and also passive active. By passive active, I'm talking about skills like this one, Ring of Flame, which you trigger, you have to have a shortcut, a hotkey assigned to this one, and you go to trigger it, and this one remains active for forever until you get killed or something like that. This is the only limitation. Have you seen an indie game with the name Gunfire Reborn? No, Jadens, no, I haven't. All of these upgrades are just compacted in the last few years, but on an old platform, could we hope? Yeah, CK. Hello, Kukos. CK, we can certainly hope for a Titan Quest 2 game. But we can only hope, we don't know. We don't have any official info that a Titan Quest 2 game will come. But based on numbers, what numbers? Well, I know for a fact that the community of Titan Quest currently keeps growing. It is not growing as fast, maybe. You know, Titan Quest is not the most popular action RPG game out there. It is a classic one. Older players of this genre know of this game. Many younger people, younger players, new players of this genre, many of them have never heard of Titan Quest. But I guess everybody have heard of Diablo. And nowadays everybody have heard of Path of Exile. So, Titan Quest keeps growing. It doesn't grow super very fast, but it keeps growing. It has a stable community, and it keeps growing. I know this for a fact. It is not. I don't believe it. I know it. I have this channel. I run this channel. I know. Now, many people, many fans of Titan Quest, have asked many times, officially, in the Facebook page of Titan Quest, the official page, in Reddit, in Steam forums and whatnot of this game, they have asked for a Titan Quest 2 game, a sequel to this game. They have also been asking for more DLCs for this game. The company knows. The community wants a new game. The company knows. The community wants more content for this game. They know. From a business point of view, I think that it makes very much sense for the company to create a Titan Quest 2 game. Because they have a stable community, which keeps growing slowly but steadily. And they know as well that new games, especially of a classic franchise, may attract more, many more players. Many more. And a sequel of Titan Quest could very well bring many more players to this franchise than what a new DLC of this game could do. So, there is a very good probability, a very good chance that we will get a Titan Quest 2 game in the future, but again, this is not official info. It is just my personal speculations. Are we going to get one? I don't know. Is there a chance that we will get one? There is a good chance. Yeah. Do I want to get one? Absolutely yes. I got nothing more right now when it comes to video games than getting more content for this game and at the same time getting Titan Quest 2. Will this ever happen? I have no fucking idea. You don't know if you like more Titan Quest 2 with a lot of changes or Titan Quest 1 with more upgrades. Hello, Eureka.
Why did you say forgive me? I fear I may have been warrior. Warrior, your example.
Let's hope that the company will decide to let the community know about the future of Titan Quest as soon as possible as well. I would like to know, is there going to be a future for Titan Quest as a franchise? But you know, I would like to know officially. I would like them to come out and say officially, yes, we are going to have more stuff coming up. Without having to say exactly what stuff. If they come out and say, for example, after 5 months from today, if they come out and say officially, we are going to make more stuff for Titan Quest franchise, this is enough. Of course, everybody will start speculating, okay, what are they going to do? Are they going to make a new game? Or are they going to make something more for this game? Or are they going to make a spin-off game? Nobody knows. But at least we will know that this is not it for Titan Quest. Yeah, I cannot pick up this Jade figurine because I have it already in my stash, inventory. And you can only pick up one. So, Jadens, are you going to play the new expansion of Poe? How do you feel? You don't know. You'll tell me in 10 days. Wait, Zedens, why 10 days? Is this expansion releasing in 10 days? I'd like a new Titan Quest game just so there can be more sophisticated character creation beyond your character Zedder Tunic. Yeah, I would also like this thing, Raphael, yeah. You've played a lot of Delirium. Opa, what is that? Mongol Sakram, Mastery Frequent Sakram. I think it is 16 days from now, but I stay away from Poe for 10 days. Aha. This is a good idea, Jadens. Maybe you need a break. You should take a break from Poe. Stop stunning me all the time, please. Come on. This build is so strong, at least in epic difficulty. Let's hit the bell. My attacking speed is out of this world. Okay, Jadens. Get some coffee. Coffee is awesome. Καφές τελείωσε. Vasily, I still have some coffee. Ah.
We are working hard to take back Chang'an. These are
the terracotta. I guess I shouldn't blame them.
Terracotta soldiers. I always, in this game, I always enjoyed very much destroying these terracotta soldiers. For some reason it feels very nice, very satisfying to destroy them. Maybe it is because of the audio effects when you hit them and when they get destroyed.
Hail! I wish I could Emperor Huangdi.
What do you think of a reforged version with better graphics, more modern edge, and massive endgame content instead of 3 difficulty levels? Yes. Yes. Absolutely yes. If they could do this, if they could do this, yes, yes, yeah. But the same campaign and music, which is awesome, then the devs could regularly expand the game with... Yeah! Eureka, of course, yes, this would be perfect. Of course, look, many players that have already played this game in the past, they probably wouldn't buy this new version of the game, because it would still be the same game, the same quest, the same world, but with better game engine and maybe more coded and game coded. So I think that such a version of the game wouldn't sell as much as a totally new game would do. But I wouldn't say no personally to this one. Night Phoenix, what is true? Coffee with no sugar. Well, Vasily, I drink coffee with sugar. I want to go to Great Wall. Dun, dun, dun.
Ah, because they are
more. Oh! One more epic reward! What the hell today? Today I got 3 epic rewards. And this one is very good, a droid loop. Wow! I think today I have a great seed in the quest rewards. What the heck? Ah, you mean it is satisfying to kill the terracotta? Yeah, yeah. I totally agree with you, Night Phoenix.
It's like memory.
Wow.
That never forgets. Sun and wind are at your back, not in your
fine
eyes.
Fine arms, firm armor, fit for the Emperor's guard. See if what suits you.
Maybe I should use these ones. Classic Vortex and Scroll of Frenzy.
Fortune.
Let's go and fight against Badari boss. Okay, let's see what we can do against this boss. Come on, boss, don't run away. I have my iron fist to use on you. Don't worry, be happy, you will die very fast by my iron fist. Just let me hit you, boss. Cha! Don't go away, I love you today. Yay! Come on, boss. Hey, boss, you are a coward. You are almost dead already by my attacks. Hey, where, boss? Ho 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 ho! Nice! Yeah!
Warrior!
Very bad drops, nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Yes.
No.
Fortune.
Wait. Ah. I have already killed these ones. Let's go this way. The blades! Pick up the blades. Wait, have I... Ah, okay, I have killed them. Terracotta at large.
You've killed all the clay warriors. With the clay soldiers.
Reward the green and the yellow. Okay.
Come.
This time we didn't get a blue reward. Hey, spellbreakers! Spellbreakers! Suck! Come on! But in the other hand, they already would have a basis to work with and the game would probably need less resources, less money to be developed. Eureka, this is true. Actually, Eureka, some time ago I started writing a text of an endgame myself. How would I create a big endgame feature for this game as is right now without having to create much many new things for the endgame and by using for the most part the resources of the game, the current resources, which of course wouldn't require of me to spend so much time creating so many new things, and it would be much easier and faster probably to do that. Your latest character is a stone speaker. Stone speaker is awesome, yeah. I have about 4 or 5 different stone speaker builds. And yeah, Eureka. For example, my idea of an end game would be to remove the 3 difficulty levels, have only 1 difficulty level, play all acts, and when you finish all of the acts, your character is around level 65 if you complete all quests and all of the things. And after that, after you complete the campaign, you unlock, let's call it, the adventure mode. The adventure mode is a higher difficulty level of the game, but you do not play the quests. It is an open world game. So You start the adventure mode in the same place where you start when you are level 1 in Illos, outside of, before Illos. But at that point, the whole world is explored. You do not play the main side quests again. You do not get the rewards again. And all of the waypoints are active for you. You can go everywhere in the game instantly. But there are also some other rules in the adventure mode that are different from the base game. For example, you have 3 times more enemies when you play single player, always. All enemies from the first one in Illos to the last one in Ragnarok, all regular enemies are level 85 always, instantly. Your character starts at level 65 in this adventure mode, in the village of Illos. The first enemy you meet is level 85. All hero enemies are level 87 or 88, and all big bosses are, and bosses in general, they are level 90 instantly. Their levels never go up, never go down. They have fixed levels. Also, they deal more damage, and they have more health points. And this one would turn the game to a more challenging game for solo playing. When you got it to play multiplayer in this version, adventure mode, you wouldn't get more enemies, more numbers of enemies per player coming into your game. It is only that these enemies, the numbers would stay the same, but their health and damage would go up significantly, and it would make the game more challenging now. This way, I think we would fix also the problem of frame drops when we get so many more enemies in the map running, because the game is not optimized for having so much action. And along with these things, we would have maybe some new bosses, new endgame content, new items that you can find only in this adventure mode. And some new features as well that you can play only in adventure mode. But I don't know if the developers would ever sit down to do something like that. The community wouldn't be deceived by a rogue direction like with Diablo 3. Yeah. This ionic beam add-on is amazing. A spray kill all mobs, including hero. Yes, it is. Kostsan, I use ionic beam with God Zeus. Hello, Spirit Rider. Hello, Bullet John. Actually, Eureka, I could show you right now the text, because, okay, let me show you. Wait, wait, where do I have this text? I don't know if I, no, I cannot show you right now. I don't remember where I have it. I totally forgot to buy energy potions.
How could you pass up such a staff as this? Or have you seen the craftsmanship on this bracelet?
Five.
Bye.
Da-da-da. So, in this version of the game, of my idea, what would we have would be this one. You create a character level 1. you play the base difficulty level. The base difficulty level would serve something like the creation of your character. You start from level 1 up to level 65, where you complete the campaign, then you unlock the adventure mode. If you want, you can keep playing the base difficulty level, which is not very challenging. You can keep leveling up in this. Sorry. It is because of the ice cubes, the cold water from the coffee. If you wanted to keep playing the normal base difficulty level, you could. And you could also keep leveling up or play Atlantis Dungeon in that level. But if you wanted to have more challenge now, and also to fight new stuff and do new stuff, and game stuff, you could go and play the adventure mode. So the base difficulty level serves as a character creation and build creation level, and then if you go to have more challenge, you go and play adventure. Da, da, da.
Once I was having no need, Mysterian.
Bone pile. Nothing. Hello, Ilya. Hello, Ilya. Ilya, hello. Hello, Ilya. Ilya, hello. How are the upgrades performing? Look, this one is the Assassin's upgrade of Devouring. Devouring performs very nicely. Assassin's is totally useless because I don't play with Rogue Mastery, and Assassin's provides +2 to all skills in Rogue Mastery. Dungeon Suites had a similar concept. They had an open map set from the campaign that was meant for multiplayer, but it was pretty open and you can easily travel across different areas. Aha! I have never finished Dungeon Siege 1, 2 and 3. I have played these games but never finished them. I like that weapon based damage is about 14 and average one is approximately 2k. You mean this one here?
Thank you.
The first is a very good game. Vasily, don't you like Dungeon Suits too? Ah, you mean DPS? DPS, yeah. Yeah, this, Ilya, this happens because of the very great rune weapon skill from Rune Mastery. This is one of the reasons why I say that Rune Mastery is awesome. Because it provides this skill. This skill is a big thing for the game. A Rune Mastery in general provides many skills that you can use in many different situations, builds. And it makes for a very, very great mastery. It is very, very useful as a mastery overall. Can you explain why all mobs have level 5? Well, because right now I play the beta version of the controller patch, which is the next update for Titan Quest. There are some minor bugs right now in that version, but it is just beta, so okay. You know, these bugs will get killed, squashed by the developers before the patch comes out, so... Oh! Come on, how did I miss? How did my Iron Fist miss the attack? I was expecting to kill the boss super fast. Frozen. What? Why frozen? Το τερμάτισα το ένα και το δύο πολύ καλό, κάνει κανένα βίντεο. Βασίλη, what video? I have already live streamed the Dungeon Siege 1, 2 and 3 in Action RPG Sundays. Makes sense. I thought you were just having fun and normal. No, Ilya. Look, even if I was playing normal, in this area enemies wouldn't have levels 5 and 6. Did you inform the bugs that you're fighting for the developers? Yes. Of course, Diego. The mobs are just on as level 5 they have... Yes, of course. It is just the numbers that we see here. The levels are correct of the enemies. It is only the numbers that are... Oh! One... Two unique items. Ta-ta. This is it, Ilya. The Queen Zenobia's Spear. This is my legendary that I got from this boss now. And this is the bow I got from the boss. Sanme. I don't know how you pronounce that, but... It is what it is. right now, I'm thinking to go back to that boss and fight the boss again. Why? Because I want to hit the boss with the Iron Fist, this one, and I want to see if the boss will get killed in Epic with one hit of this skill. So, this is what I will do. I will go to the next Rebirth Fountain, I will exit the game, and I'll come back to this boss. I think drop rate of unique and legendary items is higher on Epic than on legendary. But I don't think this is the case. It is only that it is random luck, you know. Sometimes you will find more items in Epic, sometimes in legendary, sometimes nowhere. Okay, let's clear this area out and then I will go back to that boss. And I will see.
Oh, very good. Come, stranger. We have some good things for you today. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. You must be very unlucky legendary because out of 20 runs you get like 4-5 legendary. 20 runs on what? Boss runs. You know, this can happen to everybody. This has happened to me as well. This is the nature of this beast. Of random drops. Opa! From the bone pile, warrior's bracers, nice. From the bone pile, nice. 20 runs on Typhon. Yeah, this can happen. Stone battery scuffs drop on Epic, your first sever. Very nice also. I don't know, this last version, latest version of Titan Quest looks great. They have done something with the settings of the game. The whole game looks great, not just Atlantis. Yes, but on Epic I get at least some blue or legendary. Dave Rivers, good morning to you. How are you today, Dave? Hello, Larixina. Good to see you too, Larixina. Welcome. I got killed. Those suckers, Dragonian mages, stunned me and I got killed. Persona body! It's a good day. I hope you enjoy your morning coffee. Dave, yeah, I just had my morning coffee. Morning coffee. That's nice. It shows the love and care of the developers for the game. You are doing well. You were good luck yesterday. What? I was good luck to you yesterday. Really. You got your first Adamantine Sequels of Chrones last night. Look, Larixina, if you got it on normal difficulty, it was not because I was your good luck, it was because many players nowadays get it in normal difficulty very easily. Sotoscan, a new Diablo 4 gameplay came out and it is bad. What? When? What? Wait, what do you mean official gameplay video? You didn't realize it says it. You got it on normal. Yeah, Larixina, many players get it in this exact way. In the exactly same way. Hello to you, cellist! You start the battle mage, what do you suggest to invest in? How do you want to play your battle mage? Because you can play dual hunter, dual wielding. You can play shielded, shielded one-handed weapon. You can play a staff, you can also play a bow or thrown weapon, I don't know. What do you think in normal my character is in Minoan Labyrinth? No, don't farm stone biters in normal, no, Dave, no, don't do that. It is a waste of time farming stone biters in normal, no. Maybe farm them in Epic, maybe. You're gonna play dual. Okay, Celis, if you're gonna play dual, you will absolutely need this skill here, Stone Skin from Earth Mastery. You will need this one. You will need this one to survive when things will become bad for you. It is a good idea to have just a couple of points here, not many, because it costs lots of energy, this one, and it is not a good idea to max it out. You also need to have this one, some points here. And you will absolutely need to max out this one. Of course, you could also use this one point here. And one point here to be able to stun enemies. This one stuns enemies. Volcanic orb with fragmentation. So, enemies come in front of you, you throw volcanic orb, you stun them and you hit them. Currently plague battle mages and all wielder focus on stacking stun and burn damage. Yeah. So there is an official, so this is official video though. What is this? Congratulations, you've just got the professional Titan Quest certificate. We'll send it to you per hour post pigeon. Open the window. Let me open the window. Okay, Sotos, I will check the video later. Wait, is it a big video? Is it a small video? Is there any official commentary along with the video? How exactly is the video? So, right now, I'm going to get to this boss. I will use instantly this skill. The Iron Fist skill, because I want to see if this skill alone can kill the boss. So let's see. Let's find out if we will kill the boss by using this skill alone. Come on! Again! Again! I couldn't hit the boss. I couldn't hit the boss with this skill. Why? Let me go back. On attack damage converted to health HP gives you back 1700. Is the boss going to come? No. Okay, I will wait for the skill to refresh and I will go and try again. What was that? Why couldn't I hit the boss with this skill? Probably a demo, but still it is like a reskin of Diablo 3. No, it's a 20 minute video, but you can skip them to get the idea. Okay, I will check it out later. So, offensive ability, let's go with dexterity. Dave Rivers, Iron Fist is a skill that you get from this divine artifact. When you hit your enemy with Iron Fist, you deal up to 4100 physical damage along with 4100 fire damage, and you also apply burn damage per second. Should I go there with this one, maybe? I could go with energy armor, but energy armor would... No. This would be very costly. Very expensive. Let's max out this one. At put one point here, I will max out this one later. Okay, let's go and try to hit once more that boss. Let's go, the skill has been refreshed. Yes, I hit the boss and more than half of his health bar. Yeah. No, this skill cannot kill this boss in epic, but it deals a tremendous amount of damage. Video got many dislikes and people said it's an old gameplay, it even has low resolution. Really. Fastest way to level main quest line. Play accomplished hero of Ragnarok. At least for normal difficulty, it will help you complete the campaign very, very fast. Ta ta ta. To be honest, right now. Night Phoenix. I am mostly interested about the DLCs of Minecraft Dungeons when it comes to action RPGs. This is what I'm waiting for. Right now I don't care about any other action RPGs. Of course, I'm not talking about Titan Quest. I'm talking about other action RPGs. The only action RPG I care about right now is the new DLCs and the free coded patch of Minecraft Dungeons. And I don't care about Diablo 4 as well. At this point, when Diablo 4 comes out, if it will be a great game, I will play the game and that game will probably become my main game. Oh, a legendary! Today I have a very good game seed. I get items. So far I have gotten at least 10 items, uniques. And 3 came as rewards from quests. Wow! In a normal character from level 1 to 85, how do you distribute the points? I don't know, it depends what build you play. What you try to do. HP back from attack, have only 5,000. Yeah, Dark Knight. I know the feeling. I'm having an amazing luck today. Yeah, this is true. And unfortunately, I have this luck in epic difficulty, not legendary. It was fake news in the end for Diablo 4, the posts are taking God they were from Disco 19. Ah, okay. Don't worry, Sotos. Everybody make mistakes. We are all mistakes, we make humans. Should get some HP pots in your inventory. Why? Yeah, Diego, I play in Epic right now. To compensate the lost HP. Do you mean Dark Knight when you take back all of this HP, the game should automatically create potions and give you potions for the rest of HP that you will not get back because your health bar is fulfilled now. Yeah. Ah. This could be a new and very interesting mechanic actually for the game. This is a good idea. Free HP pots for everybody. Or at least for those that have a huge amount of health still. Alchemy Mastery. Not a bad idea, Ban. Very good idea. Alchemy Mastery, you get a skill. Yeah, something like this one. Aura skill. You activate it and you have it always active. You pay maybe with health. You pay with health instead of energy per second. And yeah, this one when you life leech enemies, if you life leech more than what your health bar can get, the rest of the points will become a potion for you, health potion, something like that. Sounds like blood magic. Yeah, why not? Back with coffee.
Noble war, may fortune bring you.
Aristoteles pendant of feasting, green reward. Nice. This is a nice item. But for a certain amount of time, because otherwise it will be OP. Yeah, okay, maybe. Thank you. Why? Don't kill me this way! Ay, ay, ay! Did you find a place that says Cyclops Burgers? No! Super annoying! Super annoying. Getting killed this way from these specific enemies is one of the most annoying things ever in this game. Did you get another discount coupon on Epic Store when you use your first coupon? Jaden's, I don't remember. But you know, I checked for other games that maybe I would like to buy on Epic and I didn't find nothing, so I didn't really look if I got a new coupon. You should get another one and it will get applied on the next purchase. Yeah, maybe, probably, yeah, but... I didn't see any games that I would like to buy. Hello Lalouche, you like macaroni? Yeah! I also like macaroni me kima. But why did you have to come and say that you like macaroni? Ah, by the way, I leveled up. Maybe I should spend my points on dexterity. Macaroni and cheese, awesome. How long have you played this game? Aman Vasily με την pizza. Bullet. I started playing Titan Quest Gold Edition back in 2007. Up to 2011, I think I was playing the game off Steam, because I had a retail version DVD of the game. Around 2011, I think I bought the game on Steam, the Immortal Throne old version. Since then I played Immortal Throne version on Steam for about 800 hours. And after from 2016, around September or October 2016, I haven't stopped playing Titan Quest until today, so far. There hasn't been a week without me playing Titan Quest since for about 4 years now. Non-stop. I have about 4,400 plus hours on Anniversary Edition on Steam. This will officially become the food channel. Yeah. Awesome, I've played Diablo 2 since I was 9, I turned 23 this month. Oh, nice. You just got into Titan Quest. Nice! So you are a new player. So, how do you fight Titan Quest as a new player? Food is the most important thing. No! The most important thing is Titan Quest. But you cannot play without food, so let's say they are equal. Okay. Okay, if you put it this way, okay. You play on the Switch. Targeting is most important. I understand the basic idea of creating builds. You're getting your gaming specifics and better those should be switching over to that. Yeah, I think Bullet that for Titan Quest the best way to play Titan is on PC, because this game was made for PC back then, it is a PC game. The developers have made a good job with controller, at least for PC. I haven't tried console versions of Titan Quest. The controller at this stage for PC is very good. It is not perfect, it is very good though. But still, this game is it is a PC game, it is not a console game. How about having abilities as upgrades or legendary craftsmanship quests? Skill. Wait, what do you mean, Dark Knight, when you say skill upgrades? How exactly do you mean skill upgrades? So far targeting has just become a little annoying, but you can see it getting you killed in higher difficulties. Yeah, I know. You know, some items have skill with them. Ah, you mean Dark Knight, the items that have skills to upgrade the level of the skills. This is a great idea. This is truly a great idea. How about a random roll to get one of the skills? This is also a great idea. Targeting is a problem also, but still it is great to play this amazing game. Έπαιξα και στο κινητό λίγο αποτυχία. Yeah, the mobile version of Titan Quest, I have never tried it, but I can only imagine that it is not the best to play, because it, you know, it is also touchscreen. Taka 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 taka! I don't know, this type of games, it is not really... At least Titan Quest, because it has many skills, and the mechanics are complicated for a touchscreen of a mobile version. And it is that easy to create a perfect port to controllers for console versions of the game, something like that. It is not easy, not at all. If I could get the skill in real life from Titan Quest, it would be Earth Disarmament, because I can drill meat on my face. I would probably choose a psionic beam. Why? Because with psionic beam, I would be able to open a big hole in a bank and go, you know, in the bank, get all the money, the gold from the bank, and then become rich. Maybe, something like that. But it would be hard to wipe your ass after going to the bathroom. No, why? You know, you can also always deactivate the enchantment, so... Okay! Really? From the boss, nothing. Not even a green item. Because you will burn your toilet paper. Yeah, but it is an enchantment, so you can activate it, deactivate it. Whenever you want.
Word it.
From here I go.
Poisonous Psionic Ring of Thunder. If I could get a real skill, I would get Phantom Strike because I would be visible while walking. I don't know. Maybe I would get this skill, Summon Core Dweller, because if I could summon Core Dweller, maybe I could trick people to believe that I am a god, and I would go in front of them, I would tell them, look, I am a god, worship me. They would say, prove that you are a god. Okay, I will summon a creature in front of you. After I prove it though, after I summon the creature, you will accept me as your god. And then I would be able to summon Core Dweller and I would become a god. Four weeks and no even one Valkyrie boots. I think you can prove you are a god if you cast a lightning. Yeah, but you know, Lalus, maybe some people would say, okay, you cast a lightning, but maybe this is a coincidence. The moment you did this move, or you said, I will cast a lightning now, a lightning was cast by itself because of the clouds of the sky and whatnot. So, I think it would be much more powerful to show in front of to summon a creature that doesn't even exist in real life. in front of everybody and let everybody go and touch the creature. I think this would have been much, much more powerful as evidence. So, will you play Gothic again? Fire. Probably yes, yeah. When, I don't know, but yeah. Ta-da! Oh, oh. I would choose Colossus form so I can become a giant. This is also a good idea. Van still. I would choose the big ghost warrior. Night Phoenix, you mean the outsider from Spirit Mastery? Because this is the only big ghost warrior I can think of. Or play again with the granny character. Super Beast, what granny character? Do you mean from Dawn of Magic, that game? You didn't live again. He's talking about skill from Dead Mastery. How about a meteorite rain? That way everyone will believe you and fear you. Yeah, Lalus, I know, but I wouldn't want to destroy, I wouldn't want them to think that I am a bad god. I would like them to truly believe that I'm here to help them. To help them worship me even more willingly and even more and even better. Sabertooth! Choose healing from nature. Nah, this is not a good idea. Because if you go and start healing people, maybe they would think of you as a healer, as a prophet of a god or something like that. Or as I said, it is not very powerful. Warlord's Code, it. Okay. Not very good. Or the wisp, then you finally have a girlfriend. The wisp would become your girlfriend. How can this happen? You would choose the nymph. For personal reasons. What do you think of bone set? The bone set, okay. Nothing special. I don't know. Nothing special. Po. This is how you set this enemy to go swimming. Wow. This was awesome.
I will speak for hundreds of you. What will I do now? I was telling
you. You think battle match set is really good?
You saved me.
Let me see.
Oh, stranger, you saved her.
Gives tons of defensive ability. Yeah, this is true, yeah. So it's not worth building character around it. It is, but you will have to find other great items to accompany this set. It is. You can do that, and actually, it is in my plans to do that. Actually, it is in my plans to make for each set of the game, at least legendary set of the game, to make a build based around that set. But of course, I plan on doing the same thing for a bone armor set as well. Which one, fire in your heads or storm? Storm. Hello, Edakan Gulai. Is the game playing at online with friends? This is an offline single player game which also has online for multiplayer with friends, yeah. It doesn't have dedicated online servers as Path of Exile or Diablo 3 do, but you can play online or you can play LAN. LAN is when you connect two different PCs with a cable. Or you can also use some tools to connect through LAN via internet. So, there is LAN for multiplayer, there is also online for multiplayer. For the online one, you have to register an account, and after you do that, you log in with your account online and you play with, you have a server list, you can go to games of other people, or you can set up your own game. Become the host of multiplayer, have your friends come and play with you, or play, go to your friends' server, play with them. Every Saturday we play multiplayer here. If you want to get an idea of how multiplayer works, you can go to my last Saturday's live stream, and you can watch that live stream, and see when we play multiplayer there, how it works, and how people join, and we play multiplayer. Thank you for subscribing, by the way, Gulai. Welcome to the channel, to the community, Gulai. Also, we have a Discord server. If you have a Discord account and you want to join us, join our community. We talk about Titan Quest all the time there. We have channels for Titan Quest trading, Titan Quest builds, general Titan Quest channel. Bullet John, thank you as well for subscribing. Welcome to the community, guys. For the Discord link, if you want to join, I will put the link down here. You can click the link here and you can join our Discord server. In case you want to join, join us. No, not this one. Not this one. This hero enemy is very dangerous. Dangerous. Erkin Kalkan, thanks for subscribing. Welcome. Ah. Very dangerous. Welcome also to the chat, Kalkan. Create a character which will be usually strong at game. Yeah, the bone set is not one of the best sets in the game. It was a good set back in the old days of Immortal Throne. It was better than what it is today, but you can still use it for endgame. Or at least if you upgrade it, you can use it. One day in the future I will make a bit around this set and we will see. I don't know when, because I have many other builds before that one, but the time will come for that build to be realized. Now, we are Opa, Spellbreaker, come on. Hello, NIGA. That name, yeah. Sometimes I wonder how can YouTube allow such names in their platform. I don't know. I got a crystalline build with Dream and Storm Electricity. I will also make a crystalline build in the future, yeah. Would you play another game in Titan Quest setting, for example, strategy? Age of Mythology. I like strategy games, but I don't play any more strategy games, so no. What is the hardest boss of this game? What do you think? Actually, the hardest boss of this game is the boss of Tartarus endgame dungeon of Atlantis DLC. Other than that, the hardest boss of the there is no hardest boss of the game. What happens in this game is that your build has weaknesses. So, the hardest boss in the game is the one that exploits the most the weaknesses of your build. For example, let's suppose that this build has -3% poison resistance. This is a weak point. This is bad. One of the worst bosses of the game would be for this build, a boss that deals a tremendous amount of poison damage. Cerberus boss of Hades Act. That one would be one of the worst bosses for this build. This is how you can know in this game which boss would be the worst for your character. You know the weak points of your character, and if you know the strong points, types of damage of attacks of the bosses, then you can understand which boss would give you the most trouble in the game. Do you think that it is still possible to create more set items for Titan Quest? Diego, this is very, very possible, yes, of course. But the question is not if it is possible. The question is if the developers are planning on making more content for Titan Quest. And if yes, then what type of content they will make? This is a question. What about Nemea Lion Sweat? Stats look fine. Nemea Lion Sweat is awesome. I already have the Pet Forge built, which uses the full Nemea Lion Sweat, I think, if I'm correct. Forest of the Eight, go ahead. No, I think it... What?! Do you see what is going on here? What?! Take this! Yes! Yes! Take this! This is a bug of the game of the wall, and we can also shoot projectiles through this wall. And this is why these enemies can hit you. And I can also hit them. How would you know what types of damage a boss is doing? Yeah, by experiencing the game or reading in the internet, you know, or having discussions, conversations with people that have played the game, asking questions about types of damage and all of these things. The best boss is yourself in the Mimer's Labyrinth. There are some games like Warcraft 3 that has both RPG and strategy. I know, yeah. Even I have poison resistance, Cerberus very strong. When I was playing Assassin, it was really hard to defeat Cerberus. Nature Warfare. Nature Warfare can give you... probably the most powerful pet build in the game, probably. That master didn't hit you with lightning fight was a coincidence. Aha! Okay then. Because for just a moment there, this was very scary.
I'm going to ask to go. See, I told you.
The battle marker. Ta-ta-ta. Are you thinking the Tiger Folk before opening the gate? Some plans for this summer. Wasting time, my plans for this summer is to work as much as possible on my two channels. This one and the other one, the music one, I'm planning on making many, many more videos as soon as possible as well for that music videos for that channel. So yeah, these are my plans. The mage staggers, no one believes them because they cast lightning and it must be a crucible. Opa! One mage Dragonian mage. Hades is really easy, normal. It should be harder than the other bosses. Ah, you mean Hades boss, not act. Ah. No! Again, it depends because. Hypothetically, let's suppose that your vitality resistance is minus 50%. Hades will destroy you very, very fast. Especially if your armor and also physical resistance all overall is low as well. But if you have 80% vitality resistance, Hades is very easy, yeah. So, again, it is what I told you, what I said earlier. The strongest boss of the game is the one that exploits the most your weaknesses. Hello, Jan Ivan Yankov. Where did you find your dagger of Dawn in? Nowhere. I got it, via trading from Albadi, one of this community members. If you have vital resistance, this is a joke. Yeah. Your strongest enemy is Medea. Why? Wait, Medea? Medea is not an enemy. It is not a boss. Let's go this way. She knows your weakness. Yeah, but can she exploit your weakness? Knowing the weakness is not enough. Having the ability to exploit the weakness of others is very important. Welcome back, Vasily. You did 200 runs of a bunch of bosses that you drop it? Wow. Ivan, yeah, you have to be lucky for Dagger of Dawn. What bosses? You better farm Dagger of Dawn in Atlantis. You can also get it from Casino Merchant, from Orbs. Dream is a very special mastery. Does it work with any other mastery? What do you mean? Because Dream is a very nice master, it works greatly with many other masteries, with all other masteries. Only in my dreams he can exploit me. The Atlantis boss in Epic. Ah. Yeah. It is a very rare item. This is true. Medea can exploit every man's weaknesses with cleavage like that. Oh. What do you think about this? What should I choose, more armor or more resistance? What should you choose? It depends on the build. Look, armor mitigates physical damage. Physical damage is everywhere in the game. It is probably, we could say, the most important resistance in the game. The next two most important resistances are Pierce Damage, Pierce Resistance, and Vitality Resistance. When it comes to survivability, you should always try to get the best resistances possible. And of course, the most armor possible. Epic Orbs from Casino Mercer can give Dagger of Dawn. Dave, I'm not sure. I think they can. Yeah, because Dagger of Dawn is not very... It is not a high level item. It is level 42, I think. Dream works miracles with her to make the Evoker. Yeah. You farmed the Redfish, the Impeller. In Epic, it says the Epic difficulty has the best drop rate. With Assassin. Look, with all classes, with all builds, you have, if you got a good survivability, you try to get resistances with Assassin, and since you get some armor, not really, I mean, okay, Assassin plays with Warfare. Warfare has some skills, like the Warhorn, which stuns enemies. And it also has the battle standard, which will give you damage absorption. It also has the dodge attacks. All of these things help to your survivability. So, in this case, try to take care of your resistances a little bit more than your armor. Because after all, for Assassin, you will get good armor from items. Armor items would give you good enough armor, so you should take care of your resistances first. Can you have great armor with mage characters that on quest? You can, yeah, you can. You can. We're getting very... Oh no, not this Draconian Mage again! We are getting very close to Gusau Mountain. And after Gusau Mountain, we have only boss. We have Typhon. And we are going to fight against Typhon tonight. What do you think? Can we kill Typhon without getting killed by Typhon? The Beastman is here. The Beastman is here. I think Typhon is overall the hardest boss just because he did so many different types of damage, it's hard to couple with this terrain. Opa! Come on, not again this way! Ah man, πια! I tried to beat that Act 4 mini electrical spider boss in cave. Ah, yeah, yeah, the... Yes, in a... yeah. I buy rigs with 30% lightning resistance. Yeah. That one is a very annoying boss. Op, opa! You never die to Hades Legendary. It is very versatile, but you must be very careful how you carry the other mastery, because even if it is defense or nature or another, you must be careful of what you can do. Yeah! Necros Lupus, I agree! All masteries of the game can be used successfully with all other masteries of the game. You just need to be careful to try to understand what each mastery skill provides, and try to find the synergies, and try to use all together. Πήρε ο ποπός μας φωτιά, γιατί Βασίλη? I think Hades is the only boss that you can kill in one hit. It doesn't leave you more than 200 characters. Don't worry about that, Necros. Kalkan, the most fun act for me personally is Hades act. Hades act is my favorite act. Hello, Bill. So, after 5 years, decided to go back to PoE and try a new Necro build. So much damn fun, even in early game, really. So, Bill, are you planning on playing the new expansion of PoE? The Harvest Moon. I think there was an old video game called Harvest Moon. Oh, our buddy, my son is back. My son is back. Oh, I am once again a bitch. Terminators, we don't know when the next update will come. The developers are still trying to improve the next update with the controller, and we have to be a little bit more patient. Maybe if we are lucky, we will get the update this month, in June, maybe. Who knows? I understand what you say, but the characters sometimes don't let you combine well, and that I have tried with combinations for the rarest. I don't know what you mean by the characters don't let you. It is about you. It is all about you. It is about you to try to find the best combinations and to use the right items, because even if you have good combinations, without the right items, you will fail. So, of course, there are some masteries, they have better synergies with specific masteries. For example, Hunting and Rogue is probably the best combination in the game of masteries because of the synergies of these two masteries. We have this thing, but this doesn't mean that you cannot make good builds with each one of the classes combinations of the game. You can make great things with all combinations. Hey, this is really fun, but you are very bored. But before Cerberus... Ah, you mean the Judgment Tower, yeah. Terminator as I have it because I'm a beta tester, I'm testing the beta. This is how I have it. Hoppa! A bon pile, but I'm not going to open it up. Forget it. Let's keep going. Your favorite is Egypt. You just love to kill those crocodiles. Yeah! Kostchan, crocodiles are awesome. One of my top favorite enemies in this game. And I could say in general in RPG games. Come on! How did this happen? Hello to you, Adam Ototvi. I haste, best way to drop armor of Achilles. I mean, do I need level to drop this item, or is there any boss which drop it most frequently? No, it is all about random luck. If you got to know exactly the chances of bosses, you can go to the Titan Quest database website, you can go to this item, and you can click the loot table of this item, and see the chances of bosses to drop it. Come on. I've just realized that the attacks from Titan Quest are similar to ones in Diablo 2. Kalkan, I started playing this game back in 2007. Adam, anytime. I think I says for Armor of Achilles as a drop is Act 1 legendary. Yeah, probably something like that. No spellbreakers, no spellbreakers. Yes. I got killed because there was a spellbreaker. He spell broke my skills. Especially the earth enchantment, which provides armor and oh, Adam! Welcome to the club, Adam! Thank you for becoming a member of this channel, Adam. Welcome! And this is why his spell broke my skills. This one provides armor, and I need armor. And then when I didn't have this skill on, tsak 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 tsak, the dragonians with the spears, they killed me. Act 2 Diablo 2 at Titan Coast Desert, Act 3 Oriental, Act 4 more Dark Helis. Yeah! Why you don't have pet? Ah, because I didn't go to play with a pet. I want it to be all by myself. I got it to be all by myself. Why the dinosaurs was level 6? This is just a small bug of this beta version of the next patch. Does the damage from the might of Ephesus scale with your physical percentage at fire? Wait, what? What damage? Albadi, the damage from a metaphysical. Do you mean the percentage of elemental and also the damage to constructs and devices? Yes, of course. All of these things, they stack together. Because he doesn't have to play with pets all the time. Yeah, this is also. This is also a true, a correct answer, yeah. No, 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 no. You made the other feast. No. As far as I know, they do not benefit from that one. These ones do not benefit, but this one uses your melee weapon. So, these ones can still trigger when you use this one. They will trigger, they will increase the damage of your natural damage, and on top of your natural damage of the build, you will cast this one here. So, actually, I don't know if... yeah, it shouldn't trigger. But maybe it does, I'm not sure. Maybe. We have to test it. Wait, good question, Albadi. Good question. I will write it here, and I will test it at some point, some other time. Okay. Does volatility buff Iron Fist skill of artifact? Maybe it does, maybe. Why do you think Nature Warfare is going to be on the best pet pit? Because with Nature and Warfare you get the biggest amount of pets in the game. Hello, Coheden. And yeah, you get the biggest amount of pets with this class, Zabir. And you, if you have also the right items for, we are talking about petty gear now, gear that provides bonus to all pets, then you can make a super duper powerful build. I collect all yellow items, I cannot resist, it takes a lot of time, but how can I make more money? By selling the yellow items that you collect, and also collect and sell green items. Found an epic armor that gives Heart of Oak skill. Yeah. Coheden, I'm well today. How are you? I'm okay. Good meal yesterday. Last night I had a yogurt. I had a yogurt and a banana. Boss fight. No pits, you bitch! yeah, Albadi, I went to the fridge, I grabbed my yogurt, and when I saw the pizzas on the table, I thought, okay, let's go for a banana. This music is so awesome here. Here we are. Finally! The moment everybody was not waiting for. Let's go kill the phone. Or get killed by the phone. Well, who knows? I don't know anymore. Can I actually reach the phone? This token should be more dangerous. Yeah. Legendary yellow shells for 300,000, normal max is 72. These guys are super Saiyans. Whoa! Hayden, for this build I go mostly for with elemental damage, not physical. I'm getting very close to leveling up. Okay, here we go. Let's go! Let's go! I cannot wait to die by Typhoon! Okay. Here we are. What do you think? Do you think I will get killed by Typhoon? Or do you think I will defeat Typhoon deathless? When I say deathless, I mean Typhoon will not kill me because I already have 9 deaths. Doubters out! Bigo says deathless. I'm out of water. Kostchan says deathless. One death maybe. 10% chance to die. Deathless. Okay. I will try to use this skill on Typhoon and we will see how much health Typhoon will lose if I manage to hit him with the skill. Albadi, no, I'm not going to do that. Okay, let's go. The final boss fight for tonight. The graphics look so great. I mean, my five victorious. Let's go. Okay, I have enough potions. Let's do it. Hail mighty Zeus, I am hero. Two unique items. I think you scare more blue dragon mages, yeah. Blood turn. So, This was a good battle, actually. Yeah, Typhon could have defeated me if I wasn't careful enough, but no, not really. He didn't stand a chance because I was careful.
I am black. All create. Brave the sorcerer.
I mean, take a look here now, down here, my energy bar. Only 7,000 experience to level up. I have it leveled up by killing Typhon.
Medea came to the Ick. They say Medea was jilted.
Hi, mighty Zeus. I'm Zeus too. You can easily play legendary act to angle this build. Yeah.
My son has fallen. I would not be surprised.
Word is that they say this crab.
Let's see. How many crabs do I have to kill to gain 7,000 XP to level up? Four crabs.
Hello there, hero. I've come across all.
Hello there, hero. Albadi, actually, this build is capable of playing up to legendary Act 3. Quite successfully, I would say. Because, okay, there are some in legendary. This build will get wrecked many times because. Take a look at this armor. Let's be real here. Let's be honest. 11, 10. No, just 4 crabs.
The arcane arts are no more than remembering secrets that you once knew.
Once I knew nothing. Today I found at least 12 unique items. 12 at least. Nice.
So long.
So long, sucker! Nah, act to tell you would bang you all day long. 1% lightning resistance, do you think that electric spider boss will be it hard for you? Yeah. It will be hard, but. How do you call the scroll? There is a scroll. I don't remember the name of the scroll. There is a scroll which you use in front of the boss. This scroll creates an aura which life leeches the boss all the time. It gives the life back to you. For builds that have problems against that boss, and also other bosses as well, that scroll is one of the best methods to use against those bosses. I don't remember the name of the scroll. So, this is actually I like very much this build. Very much. Yeah, it is going to become a glass cannon built in legendary, but it is super beautiful. The gameplay is absolutely satisfying, super duper satisfying, and I just love it. Guys, this is it. Albadi, thank you, but goodbye too. Everybody, thanks for watching. Tomorrow, it is my day off from streaming, but tomorrow in the morning we have, yeah, the scroll of the Byrism, yeah. We have a new build guide. Tomorrow's build is a video. It is something like a meme build. Maybe you will find it a bit funny. I don't know. We will see. So, we don't have a stream tomorrow, but we have a video coming up tomorrow. Everybody, thanks again for watching. Thanks very much to Adam for becoming a member of this channel. Thanks again to AsroCK for the donation, for the support, guys. Thank you. To the new subscribers and followers, thanks everybody. Yeah. I will see you again the day after tomorrow with more Titan Quest. because the day after tomorrow I will live stream the build, the new build, which we will see in tomorrow's video. So this is it, everybody. I'm out of here. Enjoy Titan Quest, and I'll see you.